still on that story, a number of questions are emerging, and one of them is it a diversionary plot or is it a genuine strategy in battling terrorism? That one big question is emerging from this debate on whether or not to close the Dadaab camp. And now, KTN's Coast reporter Francis Ontomwa examines at least one side of this story.
Mambo ya Dadaab na mambo ya refugees. Tumezungumza na watu wa UNHCR, tumewaambia hiyo kambi ambayo iko Dadaab kwa miezi mitatu wahamishe iende Somalia.
The controversial statement by Deputy President William Ruto in Nyeri has kicked off a political storm and a stinging diplomatic debate. And there are now fears that the utterances may mean doom for Kenya, given its international obligations. And the Parliamentary Caucus on Human Rights is fast in demanding that the DP recants their assertion.
Refugees, no one wants to be a refugee in his life. Everyone else can be a refugee at any time. So we really think that this kind of comments are unfortunate and are arbitrarily made. Even if the Parliament of Kenya wanted to remove Kenya out of the International Convention on Refugees, we cannot do as much because also our own constitution recognizes the fact that refugees should be taken care of.
Deputy President, mambo ya kuamka tu, alafu naanza kuropoka, Dadaab ifungwe, hii fanyo hivi, tumechoka na kudanganywa. Atutaki mtu yote kuamka tu na kuropoka, ropoka maneno hapa na pale, ambao haitaleta usalama katika nchi yetu ya Kenya.
Coming against the backlash for the recent Garissa attack, the lawmakers expressed apprehension that the assertion could easily pass as diversionary by the state in facing the real monster, terrorism.
I mean, as a matter of fact, one of the main suspects in the Garissa attacks was not from a refugee camp. It's indeed a Kenyan who has gone to good schools. So I think of the mind and the view that the Deputy President should recant that statement, because we are not even sure that that remark was made in consultation with the President and other actors.
Hili ni jambo la kusikitisha sana, kwa maana yule kiongozi akizungumza kama hivyo anakaa ni kama anazungumza kwa niaba ya serikali, na tunajua kwamba hiyo sio position ya serikali.
Some coast leaders have also joined in the debate, pressing for a more reasoned approach to ending frequent attacks on Kenya.
Why after Garissa attack is when we are coming out and saying that within a period of 3 months we want 600,000 people? Watu laki sita. How are they going to be shifted within a period of 3 months?
Nimesikia Adan Duale akisema ati atapeana haya majina kwa 30 days. Na yeye amezoea kuzungumza mambo za mama zetu. I want him to know vita vya ugaidi kweli ni za mama zetu. Na lazima zitajwe haraka kwa sababu maisha yanayopotea wa Kenya wamezaliwa na mama zetu katika nchi hii.
KOTU Secretary General Francis Atwoli is among leaders who have outrightly supported the closure of the camp.
Na mimi naunga Deputy President. For the first time. This is for the first time, to be honest, I've never supported him. Lakini sasa namuunga mkono kwa kusema ya kwamba ile kambi ya Dadaab ihamishwe iende Somalia.
Kenya is a signatory to the 1951 UN Refugee Convention and the 1969 OAU Refugee Convention. And whatever direction the debate takes, there will be far-reaching implications that the country will have to contend with.